Hello CD students, in this tutorial we are going to look at three common errors with respect to using procedures in your code. So here we have a piece of code where, let's just go through it step by step. We have two variables, sumBB and countBB, both being initialized to 0, and there is a big buzzer mentioned here. So BB is basically big buzzer, right? And now we are going through the cards in the pile and we are reading the card at top of the pile. And now we have this statement where we are assigning sumBB and countBB to the result of this procedure called addIfBigBuzzer. And to this procedure we are sending these parameters, which are x is the card, sumBB is one variable which is likely the sum variable, and countBB is likely the count variable, both for big buzzer. So these are the three parameters we are sending to this procedure, and whatever output comes out, that we are taking to be sumBB and countBB's new values, and then we move on to the next card. At the end of going through all the pile, when that while loop is done, we are basically calculating average BB, AVG BB, which is the sum by the count, sum divided by the count. So we are essentially calculating the average for Big Bazaar cards. Now let's look at what is the code for addIfBigBuzzer, that procedure. So here we have this procedure, add if big buzzer, which takes an x, a sum bb and a count bb as parameters. And in this procedure we are checking if the shop name of the card is big buzzer. So this is the first check we are doing. We are interested only in big buzzer cards, so we are checking if the shop name is big buzzer. If it is big buzzer, then to the sum variable we are adding the total bill amount of that card x. So if it is big buzzer, we are adding that bill amount to our sum variable, which means our sum variable represents the total bill amount of big buzzer overall. At the end of the whole task, this is what we are going to get to. And count bb is being incremented by 1 if the card is of big buzzer, which means we are counting the number of big buzzer cards. And then the procedure returns sumBB and countBB after having done these modifications. So this is what is being returned by this procedure here. And therefore we are assigning sumBB and countBB to their new values in this way. And at the end of the procedure, we are saying end the procedure. So there are a few ways this could go wrong. This is basically the use of the procedure, and let's look at the first way. In the first way, you could simply be writing the wrong procedure name. Here I have put adding if big buzzer, which could be the procedure's name, but it is not. The actual procedure's name is add if big buzzer. So this is only going to work if this is changed. The procedure name is changed to adding if big buzzer. Or we should change the usage of the name here, the procedure name here. So basically when you're calling a procedure, when you're using a procedure, you have to use the actual name given in the definition. So this is the first common error. In the next kind, here the problem is we have these parameters that the procedure definition is expecting. These are three parameters, which is cardx and sumBB and countBB variables. And when we are calling the procedure, however, we are taking the cardx, the sumBB variable, the countBB variable, but we are also trying to pass the averageBB variable, which means it is more parameters than actually given in the definition. A similar error would be if you forgot to give all the parameters required. So here I have given only two parameters. This is also not okay. Even in this case, your code is going to fail. Now, in the third error, we are calling the addIfBigBazaar correctly. We have the exact number of parameters expected, which is 3. And this is cardex. But this is the count variable and this is the sum variable. Whereas here, the sum variable is second and the count variable is third. Now, what is going to happen here is, the procedure is going to assume that this second value that you are sending to it is the sum variable. And it's going to assume that this third value that you are sending to it is the count variable. And within it, you will see this exchange of assignments. The assignments are going to be wrong. So, your code is going to fail. So, in order to avoid this, you should always make sure that your parameters are given in the exact same order as the definition of the procedure expects. Only then will the procedure be executed as you require. Thank you.